And we are back with more RVT game crew. Miss Gunjiro starring Goemon. I'm TWK.
I'm the Shades.
I'm Maddie J.
And we're climbing Compure Mountain.
Wait a minute, there are boulders here. What is this, the most extreme elimination challenge?
More or less, and we're about to see something even weirder in the next block.
Hi, I'm Kenny Blankenship.
Oh, damn it, I forgot the other name.
Vic Romano.
Ah.
Wow.
It's been a while.
I haven't watched that show in years.
I remember Kenny Blankenship. I always forgot the other one.
Anyways, as you saw, there are geisha heads sticking out of the ground, spitting balls at us.
This is most extreme elimination challenge.
And at the top, we're going to sort of meet a god.
Are you a god? No.
No.
Then die.
Hey, when someone asks you if you're a god, you say yes.
Food.
We're almost at the top. I think just another set of stairs, and we'll be there.
This bitch is toast.
We have to deposit 5 Ryo into these little that little box there. If I'll just get around to doing it and stop dilly-dallying. The god of money.
Donald Trump? No. He's a god of poor hairdos.
Yeah.
The god of money is JBL.
No, that's the god of wrestling.
Yeah, that's the wrestling god.
No, that's Matt Hardy.
No, Matt Hardy.
Just ask Steve Carino. Just ask Steve Carino.
Oh.
Maddie knows.
Oh, God. Oh, Carino.
Anyways, I skipped going down the mountain, as you see, because I didn't think it would be necessary to show that again. We're here in Folky Pulk Village, where everyone's child has been abducted.
Won't somebody please think of the children?
The bad guys are thinking of the children.
Call Chris Hansen again.
By the way, I don't think I showed off, but there's actually a reference to Michael Jackson.
Oh, Jesus.
Where?
That has nothing to do with the children. Has to do with the dancing skills.
That still doesn't help.
But the funny thing is, what is the name they use instead of Michael Jackson? Instead, they call him Jaiko Maxson.
Well, that's creative.
How original.
Yeah. As you can see here, we see some rice paddies, which shows that this is a very rural village. And yet it has some of the best dancers in all of Japan.
Only in Japan, I guess. Yes.
And we're
on the Yellow Sand Road.
Yes, and we're getting relatively close to the third castle.
Meaning after, at least before, if I not mean the by second, the end of this part, by the next part.
I mean the second castle, excuse me.
I was going to say, we haven't gotten to the second castle yet.
Yeah, the second castle, which is the Ghost Toys castle.
Oh boy.
Of course, the castle with the abducted children would have toys in it.
Of course.
Wouldn't be someone called the Toy Maker running this place, would it?
No. And there's me trying to fall on the right block so I can get the four star. Luckily, it only took me 3 tries to get this.
And again, you cut out the attempts. The internet thanks you for that.
Yes. However, I did not cut out climbing back up, because it's essential to the experience.
The internet hates you again.
It's been hating him ever since he liked Bo Dallas.
I'd like to note
that the Between the Ropes crew are fans of Bo Dallas, as are some of my followers.
Stop pushing Bo Dallas.
Between the Ropes disagrees with you, as do I.
Disagree all we want. #StopPushingBoDallas.
You said the same thing about Barrett's. Anyways, this isn't the WrestleCast. This is the RVT Game Crew.
True.
If I let's play No Mercy, then we could talk about it. But until then, focus on the Japanese stuff.
Yeah, let's kick to the game. Besides, if we don't, Lady K is going to be pulling out the SPOD again.
Hey, yes, donate $1,000. He has to play to my tip jar. He plays No Mercy. Hey, I get a new computer. He suffers. Everyone wins.
Come on.
Come on. If I play No Mercy,
I'm playing through the women's championship mode as Triple H.
Well, that women's division was kind of crappy back then.
Actually, no. That was No Mercy. I think Lita and Trish were still around at that point. So no.
Yeah, but they weren't perfect yet.
No, that's true. Still better than what it was a few years ago.
Yeah. Anyways, Yura knows an edit coming up because this is two completely different recording sessions. Because, you know, when you're just recording, you have no idea exactly where one part ends, one part begins. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah. Suddenly.
Yep.
He entered the room and it suddenly sex change.
I think there's an anime like that.
Dude, there's at least a dozen of them.
Ramna 1/2.
There you go.
Yeah, I think that's the one people always tell me about. Ramna 1/2.
Yeah, well, basically the premise of that is this martial arts fighter has gotten cursed that basically whenever they get... Falls into a cursed pool whenever warm water, I believe it is splashed on him.
Water.
Huh? Cold water gets splashed on him, he changes into a girl.
I'm sure all sorts of shenanigans occur from that, but anyways, this is what happens when you do use the fast travel, which I'll be cutting out from now on because this can be really lengthy. Because you have to watch that cutscene every single time.
Yeah, that can get old fast.
And I also cut out all the walking around town because remember that guy we did fishing for? Now he's tiny.
What did he do now?
He ate some sweets.
No, he shrunk.
Yeah, he shrunk. He ate some sweets at the Golden Temple. What did Shauna say?
Didn't the caterpillar warn him?
Oh.
if those of you who didn't get that joke, go read a book.
Read a book, watch a movie, just do some friggin' research. It shouldn't be that difficult. Just play Kingdom Hearts for God's sakes.
Google. Yeah,
there's plenty of references to it everywhere. If you still haven't figured it out yet, quite frankly, you need help.
As a comment,
Google that shit.
Yes, and this is where Ibisumaru gets his ability, and he's the first member of the group to get a special ability, which you use by pressing C up. And you gain these abilities by winning at minigames.
Of course.
It's just
narrator, about please explain. Wow.
Yes. Breaking the fourth wall.
And now here's Rod Roddy on how to fix it. Here's Japanese. No, that's not Japanese Rod Roddy. Dang it.
The only thing I don't like about these mini games is that once you beat them, you can't replay them.
Ah.
There we go.
If only. But they're very, very fun while they last. And of course, as you can see, I'm setting up for some anticipation.
Okay there, Tim Curry.
So T-Dub, are you about to? You're saying you are just a sweet transvestite.
Lady K just said the exact same thing.
Well, I do have an eye for very, very interesting fashion.
So you like fishnets and garter belts?
What did she say?
So you like fishnets and garter belts, huh?
Plus stilettos.
On the weekends. By the way, I'm just hoping that everyone's picturing me wearing that now in their heads.
Oh, there's something we haven't had from you in a while. Nightmare fuel. Thankfully, I've learned to lock my brain out and block out those kind of nightmare fuel-inducing moments, so it doesn't affect me as much anymore.
I'm hoping that the viewers aren't.
That's going to be embarrassing.
Oh.
Anyways,
we have to collect... Chick from Wendy's.
Anyways, we have to collect 8 sweets, and if that sort of monster in the window sees us, it drops batteries and it'll hurt us. Thankfully for me, I was able to do this on one go.
Yay. That's right, Al. You lost. Wait, he won?
And now we have mini Bisu powers. And we can shrink, but when we're shrunk, we cannot attack.
Of course.
And of course, a little ground shaking there because the camera's going insane because it didn't know what to do. Because the camera was sort of too close to the border.
Early N64 camera controls, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, yes. See, what happened was the N64 camera wanted to see the chick's ass.
Actually, there's
but the problem is Nintendo of America's policies wouldn't allow it to, so it freaked out.
That's something interesting is that whenever you play the flute, the camera always goes around to the behind you every time. And now we have new enemies, which spit fire.
Going on the flamethrower.
The kids really like this one.
And of course, I think that there might be something over the hot springs, but unfortunately, there really is nothing over here. So the actual hot springs part of the hot springs are pointless.
Isn't it all pointless?
Pointless, but very, very comfortable.
By the way, I really would wish that someone would make a montage of Abyss and Maru skipping and just set it to AJ Lee's theme. And to all the people who aren't wrestling fans that are watching this, that all of our jokes for the past two parts are going over their heads, I do apologize for that.
Then again, if you've been fans of us long enough to watch these videos, quite frankly, you should know the jokes that are coming.
Mm-hmm. Anyways, we are going this way so we can get yet another fortune doll. Getting fortune dolls out of the ass in this game.
Mm-hmm. Fortune dolls. Fortune dolls everywhere.
I have no idea why there are bumps here like that.
They're speed bumps.
Yeah, but I don't quite understand the mechanics of putting them there. Not from a gameplay or aesthetic sort of thing.
Eh, it's video games.
And of course, we will need the chain pipe to get across here. And I was so lazy, I didn't even want to walk the full distance. Yeah, off-screen that shit.
That was actually pretty impressive.
It's impressive.
It's less impressive than it looks.
In other words, you've basically done it so many times that now it's pathetic.
Oh, a little bit.
At least you're honest.
Anyways, we're here. We have arrived at the Ghost Toys Castle. In the next part, we'll be exploring it and getting all the goodies inside.
And kicking all the asses.